Is that now with some reason to ask?
Now it's my heart. Huh? Oh, Michael, we were so distracted singing Patty Cake, Patty Cake. I did not hear you throw to us. That's because we're completely dazzled, all of us, by baby Everly, who is now toddler Everly. We have Jacqueline Belsita, the VP of Philanthropy of the Chio Foundation here. Oh, and Everly loves the light and she loves the mic as well. We have Morgan McIntyre, who is a Chio champion and knows the hospital oh so well because she has been visiting since she was, I think, 18 months old. I think that may be hurting people's ears, but she'll patty cake again here, Everly. Go patty cake, patty cake. Not when we're live, never when we're live. We have, of course, Sarah Patterson, baby Everly's mom. And Sarah, Everly's had a challenging time since she was born. Tell our viewers about it. I know so many will know Everly's story because we have shared it before.
Right, so Everly was born with central hypoventilation syndrome affecting approximately 1,200 people worldwide. So essentially she stops breathing when she's sleeping.
We have visuals of baby Everly when we first introduced everyone to her and the challenges you were facing with around-the-clock care and how you needed so much help and support, and Chio has been there for you.
Yes, they have. They've been with us every step of the way, and we have them to thank for all the expectations that she's surpassing.
Well, I cannot tell you how great it feels to have Everly kind of kicking in our studio right now and not having fun on TV right now because she has things to do and people to see. Very different than our experience last year, Sarah. We had you in studio and last year, and it was, I think, probably one of the most terrifying moments that Jacqueline Belsita and I have ever experienced. Watching you and Everly's dad resuscitate her. She actually stopped breathing when we were here having the interview.
Right, and that's something that we're still faced with today, her cyanotic breath holding spells. Something that they felt Everly may grow out of, but she has not yet. So there are days that we're resuscitating her multiple times per day. But with our amazing, loving, extensive care team that we have at home, we're able to manage her care needs at home.
And I should let viewers know, because there's a lot of action here, that that's Everly's just gone to see her extensive care team. She's just run off the set to give them a hug. As we look at Everly now, this year, so much healthier than she was last year, Jacqueline. I mean, your heart must just be bursting.
Well, my heart is bursting with joy. And one of the things that I thought was so amazing is that Mom and Chio is helping Everly live her best life because she's snowboarding. And I was terribly impressed. She's dancing, she's snowboarding, and I know how much pressure that is on a daily, hourly basis. I don't think people can really relate. And these are the kind of families that Chio is helping every day.
So essentially, she has surpassed all expectations. And what's happening with the breathing episodes, you said that they're less frequent.
They are less frequent, yes. As she's growing, we're able to reason with her a little bit more and encourage her to take those breaths. Like I said, we still are faced with those, but I'm hopeful that as she gets older, things will get easier.
It is just so fantastic for us. We actually were showing the visuals of what happened last year when Everly was in full dance mode, with arms and legs in air. She's looking like a very healthy 2.5-year-old.
Yes, and she looks like that day to day. I mean, by looking at her, you wouldn't know anything is wrong with her. And in a split second, her life can be at risk.
We are going to share Morgan McIntyre.